Bam 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 Hai behu yashmi eino veyigal eino Ay 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 sheiniz bekardayim Veyashmi eino be enachmav leine Kol chay leimor hegalti eschem Achriz kereshiz liyoiz lochem Leloi Hai dirila da 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 Amra da
Could we not do a piece from the Rabbi? But first of all, just a word of caution to everyone, and Reb Shlomo would always say this when learning the parashiyot of Vayeshev and Vayigash specifically, he's like, and also told us, he would always say, strip yourselves away from all you think you understand about the pshat of these stories, and now start learning it again for the first time. Because when you approach Vayeshev, for instance, right, and you go into Rishon, what does the biblical critic that lives up here sometimes start telling you? How could a father love his sons more than the other, one son more than the other kids? Didn't he know that would cause jealousy, right? Seder, you've been through that one. Fine. Now start learning it again from the first time as if you never learned it before and see what comes up. So in this piece from the Rebbe, we're going to see something about the story of Yosef and how things became what they did. Basically seeing how that's what happens to each one of us in our lives as well, in a way that only the Rebbe can explain in such a beautiful way. Sipuro shel kol Yehudi. V'Yisrael ahav et Yosef mikol banav. Right? That's what it says in Rishon over here. Yisrael, meaning Yaakov, loved Yosef from all of his sons. Hard pasuk to swallow. Now let's learn it, ki v'yachol, so to speak, as if it's the first time. Parshatenu mesaperet al tiltulei Yosef. Our parsha speaks about, you know what tiltul means? Litaltel? Right, we have the lashon of tiltul when it comes to Shabbos and it comes to Eruvs, right? Carrying from place to place, litaltel. It speaks about Yosef Atzadik's tiltulim, being schlepped from place to place. Me'az hilakcho mibeit aviv, since the time he was taken from his father's house, ומחירתו לעבד, and being sold to a slave, ועד עלותו על כס המשנה למלך במצרים. And until he was put up to become the, what's the word, viceroy? Is that the right word? Viceroy, the Zgan, whatever that means. And they, I never, like, they don't refer to anybody in today as, oh, he's the viceroy of, you know, France.
They like you for the privilege of the secretary.
Yeah, and, Yosef mesamel lemaaseh et kol Am Yisrael. But really, Yosef resembles all of Am Yisrael. Kakatuv noheg ketzon Yosef. We are called like the tzon of Yosef. Each of us is like the part of this world of Yosef. Now, hava nidbonen efo bekorot chayav venivakach ki hen meshakfot bepnimiyutan et mahut chayav shel kol Adam Yisrael. When you look at his story, his life story. By the way, Korot Chaim, do you know what that means? Huh?
Resume.
Resume. When you look at his resume, right, you look at all the gigs, you see where he's been, see what he's done. The Rebbe says, they will really meshakef. They will show us, and it's pnimius, this is the essence of each person in Am Yisrael. So, tchila, in the beginning, Shaha Yosef be'osher be'beit aviv. In the beginning, Yosef lived happily in his father's house, be'eretz Yisrael. Hu haya ha'uv shebavanim. He was most loved from all his brothers. Ubetol shekaze zachal liyachas miyuchad miYaakov aviv. And he had this special relationship with his father, a relationship that perhaps his other brothers did not have. Yaakov asa lo ktonet pasim velamad imo Torah yomam v'layla. So his father Yaakov makes for Yosef a multicolored dream coat, and he learned Torah with Yosef day and night. Yeter echav, the rest of his brothers, ra'u etzon aviem velo shau arbe b'bayit. They were busy shepherding, and they weren't the flock of their father, and didn't spend a lot of time at home. Legabei Yosef zo hayta tkufa meusheret beyoter, hen begashmius hen beruchnius. Both on a material and physical level, this was the most divine time in Yosef HaTzadik's life. It's a life of no worries besides one thing. What didn't the Rebbe say over here that Yosef, what was missing? No, well, no, before that.
His
brothers aren't even with him. What was he missing? Mommy. Mommy. Mommy dies when she gives birth to my little brother Binyamin. I got it. So on the one hand, and this is it's something that I'm just starting to think about right now. Yosef's love for Binyamin was also probably some level dealing with maybe Binyamin's issues that perhaps his coming in the world caused his mother to die. Which is just crazy when you think about that, you know? I have a friend who his birth brought polio upon his mother somehow. Him coming to the world, I don't know, he's close to 70 now, that his coming into the world somehow caused his mother to get polio. Do you know what it did? You know what it did to him? I'm sure he's still dealing with it. But anyway, on the level of pshat of what we know from the way it seems, Yosef HaTzadik right now, in this stage of life, he is just flying. What a world. Eretz Yisrael, what a father. What a life he has. Zo ha-matzav shebo nimtzet nishmato shel kol Yehudi lifnei yeridata laguf. Hear the Rebbe said here? This, what we just described, is exactly the conditions and the situations that you and I were in before we were sent down to appear in the form of a body. Our souls are in a place that are, there's nothing higher than it. Chatzuva tachat kisei hakavod. We are right there beneath the throne of glory. Afufa tohar vezoch mkefet ol v'tanug eloki. Filled with purity, refinement, surrounded by light and godly pleasure. Does it get better than that? You know, there are stories about the tzaddikim that some of them describe how they remember that they were their conversations with Hashem about coming down into this world, and the fight they put up with coming down into this world. Then there are those that fought to come down into this world, and they, so to speak, say like Hashem said, "No, you have it right here. This is, you know, this is so peaceful."
I don't wanna go. There's so much up in heaven.
What's that?
The down of faith below. Little Neshamala.
Oh. Come with me, right. Little Neshamala. Oh, yeah. Very good. Very good. Listen, it is what it is. Up there, we believe in Neshamas, with the concept of Neshamas. Why? If you ask the Neshama, okay, ask the Neshama, you want to come down here? Why on earth would it say yes? Well, you know what? I'll ask you guys right now. You're alive in bodies. Do you want to be here? So what part of you says yes? There's too much guilt to say we couldn't say no.
The neshama doesn't... The neshama feels like it has a tikkun. The neshama, there's something that it wants to fix.
And that's why it comes down here.
Sure, I would assume.
Because otherwise it wouldn't come down.
There's something the neshama...
That it feels it needs.
Right. Some Ave wrote that it did, or something, if it's been here before.
Mm-hmm.
If everyone's been here once, then they did something bad. take long, right?
These are things that are weird. I don't know the answers to any of these questions. Yeah. I have no idea. But I do know one thing, that when it's up there, beneath the throne of Hashem, there's nothing that gets better than that. Yeah. Right? On the level of neshamas, right? He's saying this, what we describe as Yosef's beginning stage of life, is like our neshamas before we come down into this world. Look, it's hard down here. Do I have to tell you that? It is hard down here. It's hard. It doesn't get that much easier. It gets more interesting. It gets more interesting, but more interesting doesn't mean it gets easier. It gets more interesting. It becomes more meaningful. It gets deeper. Easier? Statement of the Gemara is so Noach lo la'adam shelo nivra. It is more comfortable for the man had he not been created in the form of neshama attaching itself into a body. Hands down. But it says, but since he's been created, okay, now look what can you do? Yes, it would have been better up there. But since you're here already, you might as well try to get a crack at it and do the tikkun. But the Rebbe is still speaking about the place, the beginning of Yosef HaTzadik's life. Agam achar kach, also afterwards, biyot ha'ubar berechem imo, when the fetus is in its mother's womb, adayin hu tovel be'osher, he is still tovel, meaning like immersing himself in happiness. Halo melamdim oto sham et kol haTorah kula, he's been taught there the whole Torah when he's, you know, those 9 months. Hanefila v'hine. Hu am osho shel Yosef, Yosef hu rad Mitzrayma. Then the pasuk says that Yosef came down, was brought down to Egypt. Yosef hu rad Mitzrayma. Nimkar le'eved, was sold to a slave. Ve'achar kach hidader matzavo ledargat asir. After being sold to a slave, his situation kept on going lower and lower until he became a prisoner. Of course, you can see where he's going with this already, right? Gam mifchina ruchanit hura lo. Also, spiritually, things became bad for her. Nar tzair, a young lad, shenektaf me'ohala shel Torat Yaakov, who was snapped away from the tent of the Torah of Yaakov, venafal heisher el toch Mitzrayim ervat haaretz, and fell into the depth of darkness of Egypt, ervat haaretz. They say erva, what's the word for it? Forget it right now. Ervat haaretz. Limekom tum'a v'pituim hakashim, to a place of tumah and crazy seductions. Zaya ha'makom ha'nachut v'ashafel biyoter b'oto dor. In that generation, Egypt was like the temptations of a teenager in Vegas, first, let's say. Okay? It's like taking a kid out of like learning in some Breslover kollel in Tzfas, going from Rabbi Shimon to the Arizal every morning. That's what it was. And taking that kid, and that's what he knows of life, right? Plucking him and saying, your apartment now is in Greenwich, it's in the Village now in New York. And you're not allowed to go out during the day. You can only walk the streets at night. Okay? Like that kind of like level of just like, what's that? Right? Right? He's saying this is what it was like back then. Zegam hamatzav she'elav nikleta neshama bevo'a l'olam hazeh. The Rebbe says, now seriously, this is also the situation that a soul finds itself when it comes down into this world. He nofelet pitom mi'igra rama lebira amikta. Suddenly out of nowhere, it falls down. This is the saying from the Gemara. Here, he's quoting it from Chagiga. Igra Rama, which means a tall mountain. Igra Rama, lebor amok, to a very deep pit. Mi ma'amad shel ora u'kdusha etzel HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It was taken from a place, from a stature of light and holiness by Hashem. Hi yoredet leguf gashmi, it goes down into a physical body. Le'olam shel sheker v'chomranut, to a world of lies and materialism. Kan nechonot la hitmodediyot im te'avot v'yetzarim. So here, what should it expect? A life of battling lusts and desires, bad desires, ועליה לעבור ניסיונות קשים ביותר. And it must go through tremendous tests. כואב לה לנשמה. The neshama is in pain. והיא מתגעגעת אל אביה, הקדוש ברוך הוא. And it misses Abba, Hashem. So the Rebbe says here like this. Remember the end of the story. אך בסופו של דבר, נעשה יוסף השליט על כל ארץ מצרים. At the end of the day, Yosef becomes ruler over Egypt. והגיע למעמד גבוה הרבה יותר מאשר ביותו אצל אביו, and he reached even a higher level than had he just stayed by his father in that world of don't bother me, I'm pure. Right? גם מבחינה רוחנית התעלה מאוד. Also spiritually he became very exalted and elevated. He's called Yosef HaTzadik. Why is he called Yosef HaTzadik? The Rebbe says, כי התגבר על כל הניסיונות שבארץ התומה. He overcame all the tests in the land of impurity. ועמד בצדקתו ובתומתו. And he lasted, he stuck to his tzidkus, to justice, and tumato, his tmimus. Meaning, when did he earn the title Yosef HaTzadik? Had he stayed in just that, you know, safe house, would he have been able to reach the attribute himself the title Tzadik? No. He got this title Tzadik because, only because he went through the trials and tribulations of this world. Omnam. Yosef urad mitzrayma. It's true, Yosef was taken down to Egypt. You see, it doesn't say Yosef yarad. Hurad means he was pulled down, like us. It doesn't say v'aneshama yarda l'olam hazeh. Really, the Rebbe is saying, your story is, your neshama was hulda. Hulda means that it was taken down into this world. What is the Rebbe really saying to us right now? What is he saying? How much koach is he giving us right now? Because what is he really saying? He's saying, if the story is parallel, Yosef didn't decide to like be around a lot of seductions. It was thrown on him into his face. You and I are the same situation. Not as far as we know, maybe you could tell me otherwise, maybe Kenny, you have a different story. None of us chose to come down to this world. Did you choose to be here, that you know of? Did we choose to be here? I don't know. Hershey, you feel like you chose to be here? Hurad mitzrayim. You were hurad. Yeah. The Rebbe says all of us. We were schlepped down here. Hurad mitzrayim.
That's better?
Huh?
Is that better? Yeah, because otherwise they wouldn't have done it. And in the end, it brings you to this much more exalted, higher, greater place.
I think it requires then that you have to have him not in that case.
Of course.
I mean, because the other case, if your neshama chose to come here, then you made a choice.
So but the Rebbe is saying, the Rebbe is talking to those, saying, Hashem, you were schlepped down here.
Yeah.
So does that change everything? I think it changes everything.
Well, it's kind of like what we were learning in El a little bit.
Yeah.
That Torah we were learning, saying, we came into this world fighting. Or you come into this world needing to fight, right?
And we start crying.
What's that?
Then we start blowing the shofar and crying. Yeah, yeah.
Yeshua,
why does it change everything?
It changes everything because it levels the playing field, is what it does.
Right.
It first of all puts us on a spectrum of,
yeah.
I don't know if spectrum's the right word. It puts us in time, in a space of a place of space and time which we were not previously.
Correct.
Normally, I'm born into this world, and the things that happen to me, and I get to today, and I'm trying to do as much as I can until I die. But here it's saying, no, the process started way before.
Right.
Who was? You know, you were there, you had a whole backstory, and that backstory is the same with each and every one of us. We were all these really bright souls that were had to come down to this physical world, and we had it just great up there, but now down here is the test that you have to do in order to get this level of tzaddik, if we view it as such. And if we don't view it as such, then it's a whole different story. But it's the huwad, I guess, what does it? Normally we ignore the process before birth and kind of focus on everything that happens afterwards. Here it gives us all equal playing field, I suppose, from the beginning.
Does it give you koyach to deal with life differently?
Right now, I want to say yes, but I don't know.
But Rebbe says you have to remember this all the time.
My struggle here is I keep on thinking, I find Yosef until this moment to be a totally unrelatable dmut. Because we all call him as Yosef at Tzaddik, and what he did in the Talmud that he was exposed to, and the measure of self-restraint that he had, the fact that he didn't hate his brothers at the end of his life, all these like things, like, he's unrelatable in my mind.
Right.
Yehuda, on the other hand, Vayerad,
Vayered, Yehuda, Vayetechad.
Right, which is the opposite. He chooses.
He chooses to go down. Very good. So Yosef doesn't. Hurad.
But with Yehuda, the concept of tshuva is very strong. And Yosef doesn't have that concept of tshuva almost at all.
Right.
And so I find him unrelatable. But now when I look at it within this lens and understand that maybe Yosef is representing like a different relationship with Hashem. And not one that starts from birth, but one that started way before that. And that's a whole different story.
Right.
And he represents what it would be like if you actually could. I mean, Yosef had all those experiences with him right there.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
We have to reach across. Kind of explains a little bit parenthood and childhood. You think about what the neshama, where the neshama came from. You need to, like, really show it a lot of love when it comes into this world in the very, very beginning. Because it's a very painful thing for a neshama to just come down like that.
Right? Well, think about it like this now. Like, let's go there. Okay, with what you just said. A child looks at you. With what eyes? Not only did Hashem send me down here, you helped Hashem pull me down here.
That explains the
teenage. I think it's happening much earlier these days. I think it's happening much. I mean, if I now go home, right, and that's how I'm thinking now. Not only was they were hurad, my children. I helped the process of taking them away from Kisei Akover, like, okay, again, you know, on a certain level, right?
Well, that's people that say, I don't want to have a kid, I don't want to bring a kid into this world. That's
and yet Hashem says, part of what you have to do here is help me, so to speak, detach neshamas from Kisei Akover.
Yeah, but you have to be careful. This is, like, picture the Alter Rebbe if he was here right here. If the Alter Rebbe were here, he'd be like, Avot Einan, Mashal, Domel, Nimshal.
Right. Parables like, only reach a certain time. Right.
Because at the end, Yosef was in this world, and he was in his father's house, and there is some skula by being in your father's house, or being in your father and mother's house, which is similar to being a Kisei HaKavod. So really, if you want to, there's an overlapping Shalim here.
Right. Also, let's just stick with how the Rebbe goes for it. Let's not take it too much. Okay. Second line in this beneath where it says Schar Hatzlacha. Omnam Yosef Hurad Mitzrayma. Yes, Yosef was brought down. Ach ha-yerida nehefcha le-mashmaut shel rediya. Here the Rebbe is playing on words here. Yerida becomes Rediya. Rediya means
control.
Kenemar b'teilim ve'yerd miyam adyam. Yarda. There's a nigun with it. Ve'yerd miyam adyam uminaharad afseyaretz. Those are the original words. Ve'yerd miyam adyam. They'll control from city to city, from sea to sea. Shalat Yosef al hara uvechach hitala od yoter. He transformed the language of Hurad. Oh, I'm schlepped down here. I'm gonna flip it over. Yard. I'm gonna take control of it. Zogam tachlis yiridus Hashem leneshama leMitzrayim. This is also the purpose of the neshama going down to Egypt leMitzari haguf ve'olam hazeh, to the narrowness and the hardship of the body in this world. Aliyah lirdot beYetzer hara. Aleha. Lirdot v'yetzer hara. You must then control the yetzer hara. Lishlot al pitu'ei ha'chaim, to control the seductions of life. Ulehanhig et chayei haguf ach v'rak al pi retzon Hashem. And to conduct yourself in your life, your physical life, only in accordance to the ratzon of Hashem, le'or ha'torah v'ha'mitzvot, to the light of Torah and mitzvot. Ve'az, Kshetizgaber al nisyonos v'tekames ha-mitzvos, when you overcome all the trials and tribulations and you do the mitzvos, tachsof et kochotea ha-ne'elamim, you will reveal the hidden powers that you have in you. V'tagia ledarga eliona harbe yoter ma'asher terem yiridata laguf. And this is what always makes me just mesmerized. He says here, Hershey, you see this last line?
Yeah.
What he's saying here is crazy.
You come to a whole different level.
Higher
than you would have.
Than when you were just sitting by Kisei HaKavod. Higher than what we described before. And that's just the wonder of this whole thing. Like somehow you get higher than when you were before. Netflix was in front of your face.
Because we're more of a independent actor. Not really, but then we're more of an independent actor in this whole creation. And then, as opposed to just being part of the Kisei, they're connected in that way. There's unity, and your soul is literally attached to Hashem. You know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, this is what Hashem wants for us. This is what I think we were created for, the purpose of being independent actors.
Yeah.
You know, for whatever reason that is. You know, that's a realization of that.
Yeah.
Rabbi has in his Chaburos Yutzei Fatzadeh, he quotes the Zohar on this. So he says, you know, Yosef's known as Hatzadik, and he seems to, because of his ability to have handled the advances of Potiphar,
right,
and Shmir Sabris. But we know from other Midrashim that actually Yaakov was like totally like clean when it came to this. So he himself had never spilt a drop of seed. And when it came to Potiphar, they actually say he spilled 10 drops. Yosef had spilled 10 drops. And so, like, why is he known as Yosef HaTzadik, mm-hmm, in this particular union? It should have been Yaakov, if anything. And so it's because that he was, in fact, involved in this union, and he did, in fact, spill some drop, and nevertheless, he hung in there. He didn't throw the towel in.
That's what
I'm done. That's why he's HaTzadik. That's why he's HaTzadik. This is Zohar that says this.
Wow.
It wasn't like a promotion. Right. Well, he read the Zohar.
We don't refer to Yaakov HaTzadik, Yaakov Avinu.
That's correct.
Yosef HaTzadik. Had he just stayed in Yaakov's world, in the tent, maybe he would have gotten the title Avinu.
Yeah.
There would have been,
mm-hmm,
yeah, Avram, right, Yitzchak. Would have been Avram, Yitzchak, Yaakov, Yosef. Mm-hmm. And however, though,
not too many get Tzadik.
No, not too many get Avinu either. Meaning, right, either way. But yeah, who gets Tzadik?
There's more Avinus than Tzadiks.
Interesting.
The first Tzadik, yeah.
Him. So I think like this Torah. I mean, it's bichlal. It's beautiful to, you know. Learn the parsha like this obviously changes everything. But Alavai, the Midah of Rachmanas should grow in us that when we look at someone, what could be an amazing, wonderful thing to look at people with, like with what going on in your mind? Hurad Mitzrayma, Hurad Mitzrayma, Hurad Mitzrayma, Hurad, Hurad.
Right.
You walk into a room full of people and say, each person here was schlepped down here. And they're trying to figure things out. But they were schlepped down here.
Yeah, and now we can choose to want to be here.
Huh?
Yeah, now we can choose to want to be here. Like really choose to say, hey, you know, even though I'm already here, now that I am here,
yeah,
like I really want to, like, thank you for sending me here. I really want to be here.
Because
right
you
now
believe that I have a chance to get higher,
yeah,
than I was when I was just sitting by you.
That's like the Nekuda of Yehuda, and maybe Mashiach a little bit. Like, not even that, like, once I'm here, it's like, I know
right
I'm going to be brought to that place. So let me know that I'll be in it, and then attack it head on.
So who's Yehuda in this story of the neshama coming down into the body? And
no, so he's like,
where is he?
Maybe he's the scenario where the neshama knows what's next. It's not like this is until things change,
right,
until the system changes. The neshama
right
knows at some point this is what goes down.
Right.
So that's the neshama that says, no, I'm going to go down. And I'm going to reveal godliness into the world and bring Mashiach. I mean,
you think that's what it is? You know, I see it on a different spectrum, because he never had this period of being loved by his father, Yehuda, right? It's only told about Yosef HaTzadik that he had this amazing experience about being in his father's house and being right. The Ketonet Pesim and all this Yetter Ahava, this the superfluous love showed to him.
Right.
I think Yehuda is the soul that doesn't remember coming back. But he still has to go through this world. So even and you need to always like to reorient yourself back to a tshuva point, then he has
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
Right. So it has like that.
Yeah, that's chazak.
That's
so chazak what you said right now?
Yeah.
That's why most of us relate more to Yehuda because, look, I mean, I'd love to say that I remember. Huh?
Were Yehudim?
A, were Yehudim, but B, like, even like what he was saying, like, so I don't, like.
Yeah, I don't remember.
Most of us don't remember, like,
why. Right, even now. Right, we don't remember all the time.
Right, but we know we're here. And with Emuna, we say we were there. With Emuna, we say we were there. Back where it was. And with Emuna we say, and we're going back even higher. So Yaakov Avinu says, Yehuda ata yaducha achecha. This is what, in this world, this is how the world is redeemed. In this world. It's what you said is so deep right now. So deep right now, wow. Oh, we should fall in love again with this parasha of Vayeshev. The Rebbe's helping us. So said the Alter Rebbe, and all the tzaddikim, we should take in the Torah anew today and learn the Torah, every story, as if we never learned it before. Mm-hmm. And walk around really looking at people and saying, wow, it must be so difficult for you, huh? I know what you mean. I'm with you.